still name. So I'm gonna be playing some Bloodborne, and we will be talking some more. Yes. I always play female. Am I doing the first male? Let's do female. Age. Don't really care. I'm gonna be playing. I love my skill and blood tinge builds. It's the one of those skill, but yeah, this. Appearance. I don't really care much. Hair. Kind of weird how they mix genders here. We are doing. Oh, she looks old. I'm gonna change the age of her. I just want the ponytail. Hair color. We're just doing a red. A red and blue. Okay, let's see what we get. Some purple thing. 7 and. Yeah, some purple stuff. Back. That. H, we're doing that. Great! Let's do this. So I haven't really decided on a weapon yet. I might go the safe from the DLC. I haven't played with that before. It's fairly easy to get. That's not really important. Anyways, we're starting with the axe, because the axe is great. So, let's just start off with like some basic what happens. Most people probably know the start now.
Good.
Yeah.
All signed and sealed.
So this guy, no fucking clue who he is.
Let's begin the transfusion.
And this is first of all, we get the transfusion here, and there are a lot of like different theories about this.
You may think it all a mere bad dream.
The weird thing is the blood is a weird color here. Like if you look at the cutscene, before. I think I might skip this. Everybody's seen this. No, wait, well, wait a bit. There's a cutscene before this where it's clear that the color of the blood dripping in is not white. It's not red. It's some white color, which is normally the blood color of kin. And since we are in a clinic. The name was comforting. Since we are in Yusefka's clinic, fuck off. Kind of interesting how, if it's later, there comes the fake Yusefka, which we'll also talk about when we reach that. Who, like, she experiments with the kin blood. So I'm going to be talking more about that later. But for now, okay. Messengers, this is kind of interesting. The messengers are kind of weird. First of all, the design kind of reminds me of the giants from Dark Souls 2. But we don't know what saves us from the werewolf. It's just some fire thing, it can be anything.
You found yourself a hunter.
And clearly, the messengers are working with the doll. And a lot of theories about the doll, but all of this we'll be getting into. Okay, we're alive, we got nothing, blah blah blah. Seek pale blood to transcend. This is the first thing we know. So what is the pale blood? We don't know. This would be great lore playthrough. Let's turn this down a bit. It's okay. The pale blood is really not something anybody should, but nobody's really sure of anything, because let's be real, it's a Dark Souls game, it's a From Software game. I beat this guy without weapons. I'm not gonna really want to. This sounds really fast in this game. This deck is so hard. Not a touch though. Actually no reason to do this. Just waiting. And I died! Great. Anyways, encounter this guy. sorry, a bit of a cold. We wake up and the first thing we see is seek the pale blood and the hunt. Which is our only motivation until we talk to our first NPC, which we'll be getting to very shortly. I'm gonna skip this because, let's be honest, nobody cares. Everybody's seen this before. Thank you all. Yes, I'm taking the hunter's axe. This is the best weapon. I'll be taking the pistol, my favorite. And yes, thank you. Everything's closed right now. Let's just put this on. And then let's remove that hat. Not like that. So the messengers is kind of a weird thing. It's a weird entity because they clearly exist outside of the dream. The dream's not active yet. It's where we go when we died. And is that because we got the blood transfusion? Or is that because the messengers kind of chose us? Because clearly she says, you found a hunter. And the doll says that. So it's the messengers who select the hunters, so it's probably not the blood transfusion which lets us, well, yeah, it's clearly, it's probably not that which is letting us reach the hunter's dream, because it's the same kind of blood as what we find in kin, and we don't really experience any kin in the stream. Let's see here, is she here now, the girl?
Are you? Then I'm very sorry, I am Yosefka. I know that.
Look, if you look at her here,
for our town, but
she's
sorry.
she's wearing the clothes.
Please.
Of
this is all that I can do.
Of the choir. The choir is the choir is like the magic church. They're the ones who use spells. And we're also going to be talking about what spells are in this game, because it's not really the same thing as they are in other games. But you are thank you. There's blood vials. Give me these blood vials. Anything else yet? So we're looking to find the pale blood, and we've been chosen by the messengers, and until we get some insight, which we'll also be talking about what is, we can't really do shit. Can't level up, can't do anything until we know. So we gain enough insight into how this world works for us to level up. This is, by the way, this is my favorite time of the game. Because the colors here, and like the light. Ah, it's so good. Item here. So our first enemy is the werewolf, and then we have these. Like, can you say something? Just so we can talk about it. Like, this guy is clearly becoming a beast. Okay, I'm just gonna kill him. All of the humans we meet, humans, they clearly devolve into something more beast-like. But they are asking us to go away. They're scared of us. So the question is why they're scared of us. And there's a lot of different reasons why they could be. Cocktails are nice. First of all, we don't really look like a hunter yet, so it's kind of hard to say that's why the hill. Oh, there's the plague beast sound. Which is a great introduction to enemy, just having the screams in the background. I like this. Yeah, thank you. So this is our first NPC that tells us a bit more.
Ooh, you must be a hunter.
Yeah, we're from outside, like him.
I don't think that I'm willing to help. This time, whatever your reason, whatever can be gained from pale blood. But if it's blood, the charge control across the valley to the east and deep within the birthplace, Yarnamites. Normally, the hunt is on. Across the deep,
yeah, okay.
That's your best
so,
bet.
As he says, the healing church is in charge of blood. And he's an outsider who came to Yarnam to get healed. He's sick before. And he's here to be cured of his sickness. And the reason why Yarnam became such a huge town with all the power they have is because they can cure any disease. Of course this has some sort of implications. The implication being the guy we see here burning. But besides that, it's pretty great. Both of you. I'm just gonna do some quick things. Like, I really enjoyed that presentation. Like, you know from various Souls games, previous Souls games, that shields are great. First, you meet one enemy with a shield, right here, and your shield is nothing. You just go straight through it. I'm just gonna heal up the guy here. Now, why this guy's here, I can't explain. He shouldn't be him. Ah, suck. Ugh, you're terrible at this game. Can I kill him? Yeah, fuck you. I'm sorry about this. There will be a lot of swearing in this playthrough. I swear a lot playing these games. Oh, shit. Really? This guy geographically have a hard time being here because he's home. He's close to Hamburg Channel Lane, like when you go for the witch. Doesn't really make sense him being there. Like, there are a lot of other NPCs where the placement of them makes clearly sense. Like, they come from the forest, and that's why they affect the place. But his placement is kind of weird. Fuck you. I love the parry mechanic in this game. You're going to be seeing me using it on pretty much every boss I can, because I was not huge on parrying in the other games. So many bosses, it's so much easier. I forgot, dude, it's been a while since I played this game. So, as you can see here, they're burning a huge werewolf, and all of them standing there, and they're using fire, and they're coming after me. Oh shit. Like, for some reason these guys are hunting. They're not hunters, but they're clear hunting beasts as they stand there burning them, and they are throwaway and beasts, we refer to. The reason they probably can't tell we're not a beast is because they have fallen so far into this beasthood of their affection. But it's because some of the later shirtmakers, I think it's Ludwig? Decided that the Beast Scourge was too much and he needed help. So he decided to take the normal population and give them weapons and give them gear, which we'll also be seeing when we get our first proper items, and got them to fight the beasts. And that was also why these guys are dropping the quicksilver bullets, because they're not supposed to have them. And a dog. Like, they have no. Oh shit. Stupid thoughts wrong. They have been called into the hunt. I'll be showing you the item that tells us this. And this is late, this is very late in the progress that they're called in. It's after German. Was the first answer, which I will also be talking about. Like, I'm trying to save some things for when we reach it, or well, when it becomes clear, lore-wise, why this is happening. I'm not sure. This is, by the way, the best, like, the arrows in. The arrows in Dark Souls 1, so dodging those were really good. It was a loud sound, it moved very slowly and so on. This game is much faster, so it's pretty much based on the second you hear the sound, you have to dodge. That was not necessarily the case in Dark Souls 1, where the arrow was moving very slow. And that's where it's shitty in Dark Souls 2, because it's really inconsistent how quick something fired. Through this game, I'll be talking a lot of shit about ranged enemies in Dark Souls 2. I actually think Dark Souls 2 is a good game, but the way they reused ranged enemies and reused enemies for what I call false difficulty is one of the big issues with the game. So if I make references to that, I'll talk about that eventually. I haven't really decided what I'm going to do. I'm probably going to start recording first. I'm not really sure I'm going to do this. Now it's time for the fun guy. These guys, I have no explanation for why these are different. I don't know what they were before. I don't know why they're different from the different villages. I have no idea. Whoa, shit. Okay. That hurt. But they are different. We're gonna equip that, because that is... I love my torches. They're so good for some enemies. But yeah, they've been called into the hunt by Ludwig. And this is at a point, this is after that the entirety of Old Yharnam, which I'll be returning to. Old Yharnam has been burned down. It was infected. And they tried to cure the disease. But it just eventually led to more people being beasts. And so they decided to burn that down with the help of the hunters, Boom Squad, I call them. I forgot the name. Something like that. Boom something. The guys who like explosive weapons. Can you just come? I hate dogs in these games. Like everybody who's ever played Dark Souls, the first thing you should always kill is the dogs. Which sounds brutal and evil, but you have to. They are dicks. It's really hard to talk and play this game at the same time. I'm just gonna put that out there. I've never tried playing and talking like this at the same time. It's kind of... I'm the only one who's very quiet until I die and I start swearing profusely. Start swearing a lot and hate everybody. I tried to use a word there which I was not sure fitted. The joys of not being from the country. So, quick instruction for everything here. We're gonna move down to the dog area first. Because I want to talk about Eileen a bit and the first person we have here. Like, this is interesting. The reason these guys are not affected are the incense.
I don't reckon you're from round. Well,
So they continue the great, great tradition of sleeping and laugh. For no reason. So the incense, for some reason, scares the beasts away, which is very weird because we never really used that as a thing in the game. Oh, this is the way back to it. Yeah, fuck that. I never really understood why they never really used this mechanic, because we have the tools for it. We have the torch, which scares away the guys in Old Yharnam. Which is very basic. It's very useful because it gives you a breather from them coming at you with a weird weapon they have there. But they never really use it for anything. Hey, girl. Yeah, do you have any safe places? So she's a bitch. She continues to be a bitch until she eventually goes insane and then likes you. Some weird reason. Well, not a weird reason, she becomes more and more insane. Everybody does in this game. Every Souls game. But, no! The biggest piece of shit. That's really lucky I didn't fall all the way down. Oh my god. Oh, I didn't. Okay. One thing I never really understood about this weapon is it doesn't really fit into hunter imagery, like this big axe. I feel the same way with some of the other weapons. Like, they keep talking about how the hunters are so sophisticated. Oh. Wow. And like, the quick weapons and the slow weapons don't work. And this is just like the best weapon you can use early. And it's not even that quick. It just knocks down everything and there's a huge range. So this is Eileen.
Oh. A hunter, are
and
you?
She's interesting. If you fight her, outsider. She talks about also knowing
what
about the dream.
You've been caught up in.
So she tonight, has been in the same situation as us. She's also from the outside. And she
prepare you, Theron. Still, what's wrong? What are you in a hunt?
Okay. So she comes from the outside and she's called the Hunter of Hunters. Her job is killing the hunters which go insane or are evil. Some of them likely are, like, I say like too much. A lot of the hunters, especially the ones wearing the black robes. Oh shit, that was not good. Did I just... Oh my god, I never died. What is this? Okay. I'm just taking my controller out of the charger because I'm not sitting right and I'm making up bad excuses. Shit, that was terrible. Oh well, okay. Let's focus a bit. So, Eileen, Hunter of Hunters uses the Blades of Mercy, which are interesting because the Blades of Mercy uses the same metal as German's scythe, side riot. And German talks a lot about Mercy. There are a lot of theories that the Blades of Mercy is actually German's second weapon, which makes sense. It uses the same metal. She fights a guy who uses quickening and talks about, I'm just going to run past all of you. Actually, no reason to fight you. You're not given our experience of souls and lucky kills, whatever. If we look at her clothes, we can see that she's a foreigner. She comes from outside. And when she dies, they like a sky burial, which is really, really neat, but I have no idea what that consists of in this game world. I don't know what a sky burial is. Like, normally I would have assumed... I'm not assuming that. I take that back. Is the dog coming out? It is. These messengers, actually? What do these look like? Those are messengers around that thing. What is that thing? Is that a bell lady? Huh, interesting. So, she comes from a different place, like us. She hunts the hunters who goes insane. She knows some of the older hunters. There's a lot of theories that she's actually a student of them. Which is really hard to say. The weapon probably was German's at one point. That would make sense since it's the way it's made and it's way of fighting and everything. But saying she's... I mean, she's old, but she's not as old as German. Because if we look at the story of Bloodborne, it takes place... How many years would we say this crosses from? I mean, it covers a lot of years if you talk about the Thumerian challenges. But if you just look at Yharnam itself, the city, we can. I mean, Willem is still alive, and there could be different reasons for that. But I think we should probably presume 100 to 200 years. The story in this city takes place. It doesn't feel like long enough, and the villagers still have. Not completely succumbed, and I mean the problem starts a long time before the villagers start going insane. It just starts with a few places and eventually evolves to everybody being completely insane. Let's see, I really want those weapons down there actually, just for the collection. hate rats and dogs. Actually, I hate every animal. Why are you up there? I hate animals in these games. They're really hard to read. They have weird movements. They just make it a challenge. I really like Miss Bosses. I cannot reach that item, can I? Can you come down? Thank you. Except for the pigs. The pigs are pretty easy. I might have to boost my vitality here. I'm going to do that for quite a while, but I might have to do that eventually. What was I talking about? Yeah, Eileen. So, Eileen uses a weapon 100% coming from the workshop. There's no argument about it coming from the workshop. It consists of the same metal as German's items does. It fits the fighting style of every Yanamite. There we go. Now we can level up if we want. We don't. I kind of want to get the hunter set first. So it comes from the workshop, and it seems to be an inherited title. And there's always only one. Like, it's always referred to as the Hunter of Hunters. It's never the Hunters of Hunters or something. It's always. I think if we. I don't have the item here because it's early in the game, but when we get her set, we will get her set. It's really, the phrasing is very, there's only one. It seems very intentional that it's made in that way. Which is really, it's interesting, because that means there's always only one. And she slowly, also if you don't help her with a quest, she also goes insane, fights you instead of the, what's it called, Blood Crow? Whoa. Did you climb up the... Yeah, you did. Oh. I didn't know you could do that. Oh, I kind of want to watch him climb up that. That would look interesting. So we have Eileen, and she is one of the quest lines, and she is coming from the workshop, and there's always only one. Yeah, that's kind of what I want to get into with those. So already early, they had trouble with hunters going insane as well. And we are introduced to quite a bit of them. For example, Henrik, who we'll see fairly soon after Gascoigne. I think it's after Gascoigne. It's this way of fighting. He's really, really old, unnaturally so. A tragic long life, I think is the exact description of him. Which is really fucking cool description. Very, very cool what it explains and how you kind of feel about the character. yeah. Anyways, I just want to talk a bit about how the story of the city proceeds. Not too much into detail, just how it happens. The basic idea is that Bergenworth, which is a place we will reach, we will reach every place in the mansion, actually. I can't really remember a place you don't know. They're very good at not doing something you can't see. In Bergenworth, beneath it, they find these. They find these old tombs, chalices. Are we just going to refer to them as chalices? Because we go there and it's the chalice dungeons. I will not be going into the chalice dungeons, I think, in this playthrough, because let's be honest, the chalice dungeons are boring as shit. If I go there, it's for the beast claws. That is the only reason I can really get myself to... Did you seriously both land on... Great. Thank you. What's it going to say? Yeah, Bergenworth. Bergenworth finds these challenges where they find... Where a long time ago had been a different, what you could say, civilization down there, based around this idea of this great one. By the way, great one, you will never get an explanation for what it is. There's nothing that is really sure what it is. We just know it's one of these OP fuckers. Like, we become one in one of them means, but we're not even sure what that means. And, well, it's one of those things you can't really explain.
Some people try to, because that's fun and it's how the community works, which is great. I mean, I love all the lore and stuff. I love reading information and so on. But it's not really what we're going to be focusing on. Wow, I really need to keep, like, focused on what I'm supposed to say. Is that? Beneath Birkenwood, they find these caverns, let's call them caverns, where they find a great one, which is pretty much a god. And the guys who find this are the Fumerians, which is an ancient civilization, also starts to be about this god, and they cherish it, and they even make statues, and the entire culture is suddenly about this great one, and they probably also use the blood. Blood administration. That would mean they're much more advanced. A long time to pass since they can work with blood. Like, there's a very weird story element to that. Anyways, they find this old one, and a great one. And they start to probe into it and start to figure out things about it, and following, they fight this, suddenly their community changes, and they decide to choose a leader. They never had a leader before, which I also talked about at one point, some item description. And this leader becomes Queen Yharnam, which is what this city is named after. And there's a lot of stuff with her. Thank you. That's just going stall over. We'll talk about that in a second. Anyways, Birkenworth, Master Willem, finds this place and starts talking about, and he figures out exactly that the blood can be used for blood administration and for healing and so on. So he takes the blood and proceeds to experiment into it, and he quickly realizes the blood is dangerous. But he decides not to use blood. But he has some students, one of them being Lawrence, who is the creator of the Healing Church, who we'll see cutscene after I kill what's her face, Amelia. Where we see them talking, where Lawrence leaves Birkenworth and Master Willem to himself, and he leads to the blood, creating the Healing Church, where they can heal any disease using this blood they found in the old cabins underneath Birkenworth. And this, of course, becomes a great superpower. Another of this, we don't know who, but another person apparently brought blood to Kano's Castle, which is a different civilization. And they use the blood differently. They are using it to make their queen immortal. Which we see in how enemies are there. They're ghosts and they're the blood lickers, and they're not exactly like the beasts here. There's also some theories about that being different blood. I'll get into that later. But he leaves and he creates the Healing Church. After the Healing Church is created, we have this massive... we have this place who becomes the greatest nation that can cure any disease. People from far away comes to get healed by this superpower nation. Oh, that's it. Can I get behind? I'm doing attack so I can... That's fine. And... yes. He creates the church, and the church can cure any disease, and everybody joins them, and everybody are happy, and Yharnam becomes the superpower of a nation. This just ends blind, right? With a drop. Yes. I can copy him. Which leads to the creation of some different things. Among others, it creates the hunters, as using the blood suddenly creates beasts. And there's some interesting things about the beasts. But we'll, once again, when I get the item, I'll get into it. I'm going to try to go now. I'm not supposed to be here. No. As the church becomes created, there's a need for hunters. The first hunter being German and the hunters in the workshop, which at this point, considering where the workshop is and how secretive the whole thing is and how they wear black to blend in with the night, the first hunters, is clearly a secret. They're trying to avoid people knowing about this beast spreading, which makes sense if the one thing that makes your entire city famous and the greatest power on the earth suddenly creates monsters, I would probably also avoid telling people to try and keep my power intact. Eventually, German. Oh, we're back on the other side, so nothing really. Ah, okay. I forgot how this is laid out, sorry. So we have the first basic hunters with German and so on, and Aria, which is in the DLC. It'll take a while before I ever get to that. That'll come up today. They gain power, and he gets support from the church, and he becomes this. Yeah, he's the first hunter, and he tries to do his job. And, one sec. This is kind of tricky. I need to kill you. Register. There you go. Thank you. He becomes the first hunter working in the dark and looking for traces of the disease. And eventually, this section of the hunters isn't the only section anymore. German dies or enters the dream. I can't tell you exactly what happens. Like, there are a lot of holes in old Dark Souls things. But he's no longer the only group of hunters as it proceeds. And after German, he disappears. We can level up now, but I kind of want to go get the items first. As German gains power and people start following him and so on. Oh, I'm lucky that didn't blow. Yeah, there comes different sections. And the church wants control of, let's see, law. Yeah. This is talking about the place where you fight the cleric beast. This is actually a door you will never get to open. But I know where it's placed. It's actually a door that is in the area behind a really big one after the cathedral ward. The place where you fight the cleric beast is actually the entrance to the cathedral ward, and they actually closed it off to burn it down, which was committed by the boom. I can't remember the name of them. Boom something. Boom squad. I'm just gonna keep going with that. And after German, they created new hunters. They created the black and the white hunters. Black church hunters, white church hunters. The white church hunters were the ones who experimented on the beasts. They did not actually want to cure it. That was never their intention with... This is not the right way. There's not where I want to go with this item. They never intended to cure it. That was never their intentions. They intended to... Can I get one of you to follow me? I don't know if I both of you. Ah, shit, I suck. Suck. Oh, I actually got one. Are you kidding me? I forgot I was about to go into the door. Oh, well, sure I could open up then a second. It's been way too long since I played this game. Anyways, at the start, it's only the hunters. It's the church who takes over. After the government, it's the church who takes over the hunters. The black hunters who just walks the street looking for any sign of the scourge. If they see any sign, they kill the dude, making sure it doesn't spread. And meanwhile, we have the rest of the church, the white church, who experiments and tries to find out what this beast blood does to them, and they eventually become a choir led by Mikolaj. I'm
or something. I'm actually not sure he leads the fire. I know he leads some of the research areas, but I'm not sure he leads that. And as these proceed, they become quite powerful, of course. They are the most powerful warriors, and they use the things taught to them by... What's wrong? What the fuck? You can't walk through here. Now, get up. And... Are you... I keep getting stuck on that door. Why do I walk out there? Right. Following the original creation of the Hunters, this becomes more and more of a problem. The Boom Hunters get blamed for what happened at Old Yharnam because they didn't want people to know that it was actually the Hunter, the church itself, who killed everybody there. So this also leads to the Boom. Boom Squad to leave the church, which is also why we have the guy with the machine cannon, who I forgot the name of. It's not Henrik, it's Jursa, I think his name is. He's shooting that cannon, and he's clearly protecting the beasts. Like, he realizes they are human. He realizes that Hunters are maybe not good guys here, which is something we should realize as we play the game. Like, it becomes more and more obvious the further you progress that the Hunters are not exactly good guys. And as we, after a while, they are becoming more and more screwed because they are not doing well in this hunt. And eventually Ludwig creates the clerics. Well, he's a member of the clerics. He becomes the leader. He's the captain of the... Well, not the captain. He's the leader of... this new spring of hunters. And this one is mainly based on raw power. They change the theory from German. They move away from this finesse and speed into more power with their great swords and rifles. But he realizes this is not enough. Like, we still... Did that item just fall through the floor? Did I just... Oh, good search. Whoa, you're not dead. Which is pretty, pretty bad news. That he has to bring in the human, or the normal population. Because it's spreading beyond Old Yharnam. It wasn't enough. And it spreads, and it brings in the normal people, which we see here. And they then face the same problem that every hunter faces. They become blood drunk. And as they become blood drunk, they consume more blood while fighting the beast as they get injured. And as they consume more blood, they become closer to being beasts. And this is how it suddenly explodes. The beasts are everywhere, and everything is just dying. And nothing is good. Everything is shit. Life sucks. So that's how the Bloodborne situation we currently have is. We had the different hunter squads. A lot of them did good. Some of them didn't do great. All of them were pretty much feared, except for the first ones, because nobody really knew they existed. And because they actually just killed hunters. Everybody else actually managed to focus on... actually killed a lot of humans, trying to avoid the spread of the beast plague. So that's the current situation we have. We have a lot of humans who got forced to... who got called in this fight against the beasts. Save their loved ones, and they become corrupted and addicted to the fight and the thrill and the blood. And now we have to put them down as a person who comes from the outside and is therefore not corrupted by this. Oh shit, that sucks. Can I just bury you? I just enjoy it. Oh, you're not dead. Yeah. So that's the current situation we have. And now we will be seeing some proof of the... Oh my god, I hate myself. Oh well, that's not what I came here for. Don't be a dick. Do not be a dick. Thank you. So, first of all, Fashionborn. Let's get... I thought you had lower health than that. I feel pretty and witty and nice. So let's look at these items quick. A fine piece. Oh, this is not the one I'm looking for. Shit. Okay, there's another piece of equipment. I can't remember what it's called, but it talks about how it allows even normal people to fight against hunters, but it is not enough to keep the force from killing them. Which makes sense, because nothing in this game is heavy armor. Everything kills you. But this set looks badass, and that is great. I should probably go level up now for the first time. Pop some inside. Have fun. Not that much grab right here. Actually, I have to use those before. Going in there. Yeah. That's the current situation we're having. The blah blah blah. So, the church is in complete control, the church fucked up, and that is the situation we brought into. So they have a lot of people who've been, yeah, experimenting on people, and things have gone to shit, and for some reason, the night, there's a weird thing with the night in this game. I mean, it's a big play in this whole you're in a dream thing. Which is why you can always respawn. As always, an explanation for why. Why you return in these Souls games. But, sorry. But there's no really in-depth explanation of what it consists of. I have no reason to fight you. So, what we see over there is the cathedral. Actually, if you look right up there, the clock tower. That is where we fight Maria. Really nice, so you can see where you're actually going. That's great touch. Let's see if we should go get this item, and let's see if we can go back to a lantern somehow. Should be here. Open this shortcut and back to lantern. Yes, great. So, quick talk about Hunter's Dream, which we go to now. We don't really know what created the Hunter's Dream. We assume it's the Moon Presence, which is a great one. It's one of the few we can actually define as a great one, because there's a lot of talk about what defines a great one and what exactly is one. Like, Amygdala is not a great one, at least not the boss we're fighting, but there are some theories that every single Amygdala together is actually a single great one. They just learn how to split, but it's kind of hard to. Thank you. I won't be needing those.
Hello, I'll be solving everything.
Thank you. Well. Let's see. I could probably reach level 18 or something. So, I just want to get you two up to 10 and get you. Yeah. Oh, 17. I'll just use every single soul item, a blood item I can have, because I won't be needing. Just save them for anything. At least level 20 then. Nice. Actually, I'm going to save one in case I have to upgrade the item.
Very well.
Yeah. Stop talking.
Farewell.
And are you giving me the PvP item? Not at all, Thunderbolt. So, German. I don't have anything. If you notice, he has a wooden leg And if you talk about, if you look at the old Honda outfit, they have this theory that the blood creeps up through the right leg. So actually, he might have removed his own leg out of worry that he's becoming infected. Yeah, I'm gonna upgrade you as much as possible. And I don't have any blood gems yet. I can't do this anymore. No, great. And then we have this shop. Messages. But these flowers are apparently called Luna flowers or something. And actually, we found out that Moon Presence has a name. The doll talks about it at one point, which is kind of interesting. But it's not what we're gonna focus on. Now we're just gonna kill the cleric beast. So the clerics were this group of really strong hunters, very, very late in the timeline. We arrived soon after their demise. They were the last attempt at stopping the beasts before they started using the normal populace to stop them. That damage, oh god, gosh. Oh, it scales up strength. But as it said, they transform into the prettiest of beasts in one of the explanations. Which we see with Lodric. Is it Lodric his name? Lawrence, who has become a cleric beast. Which is, by the way, kind of interesting, becomes a cleric beast, but we won't check that right now. What am I doing? I should be blocking this guy. Oh shit. Why am I getting myself into these situations constantly? Fuck you. Oh my god, you're still scared the shit out of me. Okay, let's do this. So, this is the entrance to Cathedral Ward, actually. If you look up there, that is where one of those big white ones are, actually bearing some church guard. And there's a path that walks up to the Cathedral Ward. So this is actually, I mean, everything is connected in these games. There's a clear pattern here. So, I can't remember if you're hard, I don't think you are. Actually, I can't remember how easy you are. It's stop. I don't shit. Really good introduction to the game, but it's a shitty boss. The more bosses that are like this, the more the person who games. It's a shitty boss fight in the time. Mainly because if the damage went up, it would be way too difficult. Because it's really hard to bring them off the attacks. But the way the damage is here, you can outlast them. You can just R1. I don't know if you have 24 wilds. He's really a bad guy. He's a pretty big badass for becoming a cleric. This is also the only one where he doesn't have several. I can't get another stat in here. What should I do? Ah, well. He doesn't have any interface choice. I only missed the grab. That's embarrassing. I didn't even try to poke. Okay, I need to stop. But the question is whether or not this guy was killed by Bardo. What's his name? Radon? Bardo? I don't remember his name. The assassin, the church's assassin. Because it would make sense. I mean, the first couple of them would probably be killed by the church as they realize they're coming. I say get wrecked, but I play that so shittily. I don't even feel good about it. How could I get there? How should I get what I get there? Oh yeah, sorry about that. That's because he's part of Ludwig's group. And it allows me to buy a weapon, which we will just quickly go look at. Just for your pleasure. Every single cleric fought with the idea of Ludwig in mind. He was the big, and he had the Holy Moonlight Greatsword. So his idea was... I actually thought it was a different one. Oh yeah, it's a different place you get it. So this is apparently a cleric weapon. An interesting thing is, this was forged in a healing church workshop. And we don't know like where exactly that is, because it says in the Grand Cathedral. We know outside of the Grand Cathedral, in the Cathedral Ward, there is the normal workshop. But this is not the kind of weapon that. Why do I have every weapon? Oh, I can buy every weapon. This is not the kind of weapon that German would have enjoyed. And this is also what we get. Right, this is not... yeah, the first hunter of the Healing Church. He's the first hunter who was... Yeah, this is not nearly enough, though, to allow any ordinary man to stand any real chance against the beasts. He's the one who made the hunters become part of the church, because until then it was a separate endeavor to control these... beasts until Milk, he starts to make the church focused on it. So we're just going to keep going up skill. Fuck, I'm going to get endurance up actually, that's the next thing. Okay. I'm just going to move on to Gascoigne right away. So he created, I said something earlier, he created a cleric, but the cleric, so he didn't. He created the Healing Church Hunters, who consisted of the Black Healing Church Hunters and the White Healing Church Hunters. And they have very, they had completely different goals, and he went differently from German. German was this entire speed, agile, graceful thing, as you see when you fight him. It's a fucking piece of art to be fighting him. Same goes for the Freya, the main student. While Ludwig is just, when he eventually uses his sword, he's just firing everywhere. Like, he's not the same work of art as any of the others are. So, that was our first sidequest, in case you didn't know. We're not going to go for the first Spartacus coin. Which I unlocked the shortcut to earlier. Because I'm awesome like that. No, that's just not always possible. I always remember killing bosses like in quick succession. Yeah. So it's like the other area to like cool items and so on. So, Gascoigne. Gascoigne is king of the Black Church, partnered up with Henry. He was one of the original. He's one of the early church hunters, but he leaves the church. He doesn't want to
continue being a church. Probably because he decided to start a family with what is assumed to be a rich daughter. Which is probably why Henrik goes mad when he comes there. Not because he sees Gascoigne. He's standing looking at the corpse of his wife. No, of his daughter. Of Gascoigne's wife. When we find him mad. Oh, getting into the blood-crazed ramblings of the beast. That's a proper way of saying it. So, let's go fuck up Gascoigne. So, the question here is, did he kill his wife, or did the ones he's killing right there kill his wife? I think he did. She didn't bring the music box. It's very insinuated that he killed his wife. But he's killing a beast there. He's wearing this black church garb. Clearly the hat is design is based on German. He even has the scarf like German. Like, this is early church design. This is just after.
Beasts all over the shop.
Now, even calls it the shop. Be one of the scarf there is actually a proof he was part of the healing church. Just give us something with eyes. Like, he doesn't have eyes either. It's a weird thing. So, this is the first good boss fight of the game. It won't look amazing, because I'm probably going to parry him into oblivion. It seems like I do. But this is a great fight.
What's that smell? The sweet blood.
Oh shit. Oh shit. He's very relentless if he gets a hit on him. Okay. Lay down. Are you not going to come to the building time? Oh, this makes the beast more fun. Oh, jeez. He's very low now. Oh, are you not? Okay. So this is where it becomes really hard. It's much fun before it becomes a beast, to be honest. It's very easy to parry when it's human. It's a bit harder, but it's not. As you can see, it's still not difficult. I'm not gonna waste time. Box and so on. But like, if you see what he's killing right here, we see it's actually villages. Like, he's standing over here. Okay, I thought he was standing over here. But as we can see, he's killed villages. And the question is, did he kill the villagers and go mad because his wife is dead? Which is interesting, but if we look at where she is, she's up here. I mean, how would those villagers get her up here? They don't have the bestial strength that he does. So that's why I think he probably killed her and then went on a rampage and killed all the general populace. So, moving on to Odin Chapel. Odin. Which is actually likely the name of the Great One. It's referred to as such a lot. People talk a lot about the cosmos or space, the universe. And he's kind of... he's a special Great One. The Bergenworth spider hides all manner of rituals and keeps our lost master from us. A terrible shame. It makes my head shudder uncontrollably. They're probably talking about Rum, the vacuous spider. And he's kind of interesting. Oh, nice, I'm gonna create a weapon. Because he's likely a successful attempt at creating a Great One. By Willem, which is amazing. Like, everybody else is trying to create a Great One, and Willem, he just Oh, just great one. I'm awesome. I'm not gonna spend time with this. Where's our baby girl slash boy? There you are. Hey, babe.
Very good. These hands.
Like, she's blind.
Not waiting for it to end. But end nicely. Screams of women, yarns. But if you spot, tell them about. They'll be safe. Spread the word.
Okay, let's just.
I know what if they seem. Oh.
They don't have 7 million things that have to be exhausted before you can go on. So, quick little run through that. That was easy. Odin Chapel. Odin is referred to as a great one by some. Oh, what is she saying here?
Welcome. What is it?
Can we talk about?
Over time, countless hunters have visited this
tree. All of
the
tombstones we see in a different area.
The graves here stand
and also
in
down
memory.
There. They
it
are
will see.
Different hunters that have been going through
over
the dream.
Time, it very well let me.
Now, let's see. I can afford 2 levels of a proper item. Let's just. I hate you're not 10. I'll wait till a level. I was only going to go into it. No, that's a 1,000 scope. Okay. Like messengers here, blah blah blah. By the way, this is very interesting because there's something that looks a lot like this, both in Dark Souls 1 and Dark Souls 2. Yeah. So, we're going to put the gem we just found into our weapon, because we are morbid like that. Oh, it can't go in? Oh. Shit. Bring my gun. Upgrade my gun. Oh, I have to use it for. I'm not gonna give it to the kid. If I leave her there, she will survive. If I don't, she will die. I'll get killed by the pig. I'll get a ribbon for my messengers, but I don't really, not care. So, Odin is actually a great one, but this one is, he's not corporeal. He doesn't have a body. It feels like he's the universe itself. There are a lot of talk about this in some of the weapons in the choir and items in the choir, but I won't really. Like, there's a theory about this. I can't really. I don't know personally. There's a lot of reference to him being a great one. He is a great one. But we don't really know what he is. I'm not gonna presume to know what exactly he is because nobody really fucking knows. Ah, stop sucking. Shit. I wanna go into old Yharnam, but we're just gonna do this first. I think we need to clear out the area. Thank you. And I remember this game shit out of me the first time. So, like, this is the way to ensure you get to hunt this loot before you go on. Is this different? Yeah, allows one to stalk beasts unannounced. Oh, I actually like this. Okay, more. Yeah, I definitely like this one more. Yeah, that's from back. This is even not what we need to know. That shit was fucked up. Why am I using the shotgun? Wait, could you attack? Good. So this guy is clearly a member of the choir. Oh no, not necessarily the choir, of the church. Because if we look at his hat, no. If you look at... You. Stop sucking.
his shoulders back, it's... Oh, well, not good. Bad idea. Oh, well, there'll be more. If we do the shoulders back, it's the same one you see on the back of Gascoigne, among others. And you see it on the back of pretty much every church outfit. Which is a clear indication that it actually was a member of the church. The question is, what part of the church is a member of? I suppose why would you like to choir? But, I mean, oh, fucking kind of hard to know. There's a lot of things you just can't really know. So, now you can fix it. Oh, you real? That was very annoying. Wow. I mean, I hate gods more, but these are pretty behind the list. Give me the monocular. Thank you. So, let's just put some shit in here. I'll put that in there. I want to put... I won't be using that. Notebook in there. And monocular in there. Oh, no, no. So, if we look over here, this is likely the place. This is the place where we fought the cleric beast. We can't see as much detailed. It's not as detailed from this viewpoint, which makes sense. But this bridge leads into here, Coastal Bridge, which is where this goes down. And if you leave a shiny coin at the thing you find down here, then how do I? If you leave one of those shining coins there and you go back to the bridge, you can actually see it on the other side of the door. So that is a door that was locked to make sure that Central Yharnam could not reach Cathedral Ward, which was like the last safe place before they reached the church. Oh, nice. Oh, wait, I don't have time for you. I have to find the small one first. There you are. I don't... Oh, shit, we're good. Yeah, thank you. Okay. Oh, this is great visual. This sun in the background. He's just fighting this. This just looks great. Ah, oh, not enough stamina. Just a great visual. I still haven't decided on a weapon. I'm probably going to grab the first and best skill weapon I can find. So, I think this is the first blood gem I found. This door literally is the locked door that keeps them out of this area. Which is great. It's a cool concept. This door stays locked the entire time. Sorry. The cleric beast jumps from up here down there to the bridge. It's cool. It's a nice way of keeping the whole world collected. It's a really, really... No, I appreciate that kind of stuff. Can we see? Can't really see anything over there which I can spot somewhere. Yeah. Oh well, moving on. Let's go to Old Yharnam. Tell me what happens there. I just heard make that It's kind of weird. Oh well. It's nice view. I really dislike those rocks. I feel like it's the same texture they use for everything outside of the game. But it's, I mean, it's out of the game and it doesn't really affect the, like, vistas they want to create. So it's, I guess it's fine. It just, it's not a problem. It's not something I really can't explain for, but it's boring. You, come here. Oh, you're alive? Dun 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 dun. I wonder if I'm going to be using the Molotov cocktails. Bloodstuff Beast might be a bitch. I might use something. I don't know. I'm probably going to use fire paper there. Oh well. Hey! This place is cool. I always liked this place. What's really interesting, everybody that has an inside on is always these. It's always a member of the Black Church. It's always bowing. And if you look at the picture of it, you can see it's actually the shape of a snail-like thing breaking out of a skull. And if you notice a lot of the spells of the game, all of them have this snail-like thing going on. Which means it's likely because of Epietas, because she's not mainly snail shit thing. It's less of the image of this snail thing going to bring suckers like snail inside of them, actually, if you look at some pictures of those. You are extremely annoying. Flash, I need you to sit down. That's lovely. What's this sound? Dun, 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 dun. So this is one of the interesting groups. Like, he has the shawl in the back. A different kind from the rest. And he has the grey colour, which is not really any of the other groups we've seen so far. And if we look at this guy, that is Lugarius. You can see he has the weird shaped head which all of the executioners have on, and he's also considered a martyr. So he's praying to his teacher.
You're a beast, I knew it. Oh, big protege of Master Lugarius, hunter of vile blood. So, what say you?
So what are the vile bloods?
And discuss them. Take this.
Thank you. Thank you. Can we watch out?
As you well, I'm a simp, but I have heard that the hand that counselors of the old church. If you
like, this is our next instruction to what we're supposed to do. And then Birkenworth
and the tomb of the gods carved out below Yarn. Well, once this led to the founding in this sense, but today, and furthermore, it's unclear. But only they know.
So he pretty much just gave us a huge, huge exposition dump. Well, huge for Souls games. Tells us we have to go to the church because that's where they take care of all the blood moving. And he tells us Birkenworth, but not underneath the school, they found some sort of god that taught them how to use this blood. So he pretty much just gave us the basic plot of the lore of this game. In 3-4 sentences, which is a huge deal in these kind of games. And you don't realize how huge of a deal what he says is until you actually know the lore. Okay, cool. I'm gonna refer to a lot of stuff in this game. Cool. That's just how I roll. Lol. Anyways, let's do this. Du-du-du-du-du-du-du-du-du-du-du. good to look here. Oh, there's nothing. No. By the way, most of my lore, what I know, some of it is from my own theories, but I gotta admit, I read this 127-page essay, which I think it's called Redgrave. I think that's his name. Red something, it's on Reddit. Wrote about the game. He sat down and he just wrote a lot of sections and like specifically. And I have my own theories, but he has a really nice way of summing it up. Like, he chooses the area and talks about it. Really nice. So. Anyways. Hunter's not wanted here. This is written by Jerza, who we will not be killing. I'm not gonna explore this entire area. The ship's cool. Sure, you got it. One sec. Sorry, I just had. So I want to get the Hunter's Torch. That is important to me. Which is here. These are cool. Like, these are clearly beasts. Why are they covered in the white cloth? We have other people who are not covered in the white cloth. Is that because these guys died first? And therefore, got affected first, therefore got covered. But they're poisonous, the others are not. Why are they poisonous? Let's see here. Oh, we can't really see them. I don't want to get poisoned. Very interesting enemies. The others are just like basic beasts. Hammer's Torch, thank you. So, if we look at this item, used to treat ashen blood, the baffling sickness that ravaged old Yharnam long ago. The interesting thing is, where did that come from? This poisoned ashen blood. And if we look at the placement of everything, this is very close to Yahagul, and that's like the only place it's really connected to. So the poison is not coming from the forest, which most would presume, but something is infecting them. Ashen blood. I don't know, to be honest. I just know that the ashen blood apparently triggered beast in them, and I assume they then tried to heal it with blood, which then triggered more beasts. That's a great little vicious cycle they got going there. But I mean, oh, I should check out this. I forgot. Oh, wrong. They are scared of fire. So, okay, not too scared. Yeah, I got it. I don't remember if it actually hits the mold or anything else I can do right now. I'm just a basic. Yeah, the torch is pretty strong against these guys. But I hate the combo. It's like, just forward stabbing. Not why it can't hit a lot. Pretty shit. But it's good. It's a good weapon, and maybe they're wearing the cloth to avoid seeing fire, as there's fire everywhere. I don't know. I'm not sure if they reacted to the torch. I don't remember. An interesting thing is, if you look at the cloths Simon is wearing. Simon is a hunter who is dressed like a beggar to not be noticed. So he can freely explore like what people, whether they are affected or not. And he is wearing the same headdress as these ones are wearing. So that means this is like the poor part of town, which also makes sense as they're the one who got sacrificed. As a lot of them are wearing the beggar's clothes. I always wondered if these are just female. I thought that was weird. Anyways. So I'm probably gonna rush through this area, because there's not... I mean, the most interesting part of this is Jerza. Jerza was clearly giving up. He doesn't want to be a hunter anymore. He thinks the hunters are the terrible ones. The beasts are not hurting anyone. And he's right. I mean, the place is empty. They can't possibly hurt anyone. So I'm not gonna be, clearing this area out for items. Actually, this is a great item. Oh, do you want to see quick trick to get this guy? To get this guy to come here. Let's see. Come on, do jump attack. You know you wanna. Fuck you. Oh shit, I fucked it up. Come along. Come along, city you. City you. Attack me. Ooh, I have to be careful here. I'm just waiting for him to do the thing I want him to do. Ah, he's not doing it. Maybe they bug fixed it. I just don't know. It made him a bit too easy. Well, it made him not hard at all, actually. Oh shit, don't die. I'm a fucking... Why do I have need to fight him? I shouldn't fight him. Idiots. So I don't really know what that hunter's doing. There. I have no clue. He's just there. Dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum. Sorry. Just 1 second and we'll continue. Good to go again. Okay. That was a shitty death. We'll be picking up our blood echoes and moving on in a second. Shit. For some reason, I'm really shitty at the game and talking at the same time. It's really annoying. I never realized how... Da dun 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 dun.
So, Jersey doesn't like Hunters. Good reason. He, like the Boom Squad. The Boom Squad got wiped out because they did this. Church forced them to. This general, not a lot of feel good about old Ghana. I will be killing you the easy way, very, very soon. The second you want to do what I want to do. I think they fixed it. That is awfully annoying. Oh, come on. You cannot be this annoying. Okay. There we go. There we go. There we go. There we go. Fall down. Thank you. Now, look at this. Oh, shit. Annoying. Come along. We have disagreements about what range is proper. Why is that going to the side? Okay. Huge disagreement about whether or not that hits. I'm so stuck here all the time. Can you just walk down here? I'm taking so many free hits because I'm trying to do this trick. It just won't fucking work. I think they fixed it. Oh no. And bye. Thank you. Took way too long. But this is like the only place to get full power action. Don't hang down here. And there. Whoop. And here. Whoopsie. Okay, we want the items in here, so here we are. Also, there's law in here, which is the greatest motivation of all. Fuck you, dude. Suddenly realizing I put all my points into skill, which doesn't scale with this weapon. I've truly boned myself earlier game-wise. I don't get how you can hit me. I always enjoyed when I did the small punches. I always thought that felt very human. Like, they clearly... in the past.
Jesus Christ, you're just gonna keep going. I think that was all of them. I don't think there should be more. So we should have some lore here. Red moon hangs low and beasts rule the streets. Are we left? No. Okay. So this is a person from before the whole thing got torched. Who realized that, oh shit, is this our only option? I think got a weapon. The sword spear is supposed to be down. Oh yeah, that is. I, by the way, love that set. I'm going to look at it in a second. And we're going to be talking about it a bit. So. Charles Undergarp. So this is worn by the people who burn everything. And I love it. I think it looks awesome. It's this cool, like, burnt cape and great visuals. So we're just gonna go out here. And I don't have time for any of these. Because machine gun dude. So I'm not gonna go up there and get all those items. Who gives a fuck? It's not important items, I'm not needing them. Let me just shut up. So, I always like this next area. You can kill Joes up there, but we're not going to do that. We are going to keep him alive for our sake. No, because if we come back after killing the Dark Beast, he likes us. He's like, oh, you didn't kill any beasts. Because he forgot we were through earlier. So, hit this. Breaks down, everything goes on fire. Which makes that room, which has a lot of enemies, is not hard at all, but it makes it a bit more manageable. And it feels kind of cool to just like burn you all. I always hated the platform they put in these games. So, let's see if I can manage to jump. How do you jump in this game again? Like this one. No, that's not how you jump. No, it's double O, you jump. Jesus Christ, good thing I checked. Okay. Nailed it. So that should be, yeah, lovely. So. We look down here, it gives you blood-starved beast. Burning. Which is awesome! And all of these just standing around them there. That I've always been wondering, because this is very church-like, like with the altar and so on. Like, are they nuns? Are they like the female nuns that hid out in the church to avoid the fire? Or what happened here? I've been wondering. Like, these ones crying looks a lot like these ones. And women have a clear, specific meaning in this game. Like, it's not a joke that there's so much female stuff in this game. Moon presence, the doll, every female character is pretty much important. You pretty much only rescue females. The constant birth talk. Oh shit. Ah, oh, fuck me. I never tried getting the rabbit poison. Oh. Stupid idea. Do I want to walk up? No, I don't really care. Oh, it's fine. It's good. Like, we have that thing there, just found. Ritual blood, and it's a chalice item. It should be, yeah, there. When all is melted in blood, all is reborn. Why is that all at the altar? Like, they clearly
because they're hoping that, I mean, the church, fear religious, there's clearly some religious properties to go with the blood. Probably didn't say it comes from a huge alien god. Well, it probably says it comes from a god. But not probably not from what it looks like, because it's presumed it's Ebrietas. Or sort of blood, and she's kind of gross. Adorable, but gross. I think a good mix. I'm saying adorable because she's crying over rum when you meet her later. That's kind of neat. That also annoyed me, that didn't. I'm sorry. There we go. And slide. Okay. Trying to kill some werewolves. In a second, I have to do this first. Gee, I wonder where one of them are. You're not dead. That's weird. Whoa. Shit on me. And that's a League of Legends joke. Yay. Okay. And hang on. I have no idea where the wolves come from, like the werewolves. Clearly every human we meet who is affected by the blood has some wolf-like properties. But like, this goes full wolf, which is kind of weird. This is what goes to Yahakul. Which is the reason why you don't see any coffins belonging to children. Because Yahakul steals them all. They kidnapped the children to kill them. I mean, it would make no sense that there are no children coffins. Those are the ones you would make sure got buried, and probably the weaker ones, so they would die first, and so on. But no, you see no children coffins. And that's probably because the church made, told people, we can save your kids, give them to us. Time to die? I have time to die. Oh my god, that miss. Fuck you. For real. Like that, I would presume that was their idea. Oh shit. Ah, annoying. Can I? Come down. You could not. Okay. Oh well. Fuck you. I might go back before I fight the boss. Like now that I opened a shortcut. Cause I would feel silly if I actually died to kill that beast. I mean, the boss is a bitch I could die to it. I feel very silly not having all those. I mean, the bullets would help. If I wasn't low on bullets, I would probably not. Unless something gives me a lot of bullets before the boss, then I'm going back. Shortcut open. First playthrough I didn't realize this was a shortcut. It was just me being an idiot. As it so happens. Dun 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 dun. But that's why you see all those guys with the sacks who start coming after you kill Bloodstaff Beast.
That is actually because they kidnap children for experience, I would presume. So that's why you don't see any children coffins until you reach higher, until you reach the orphanage, which is called orphanage for a very good reason, because that's where they kept the children and experimented on them. Which is maybe what all the small things standing mean when you get to upper Cathedral reward is. Because we find out that oh, that was 10 bullets. I might actually just maybe I can also upgrade my weapon if I want. Oh, he did not run, did he? Did he run? He ran? Shit. Well, then I'm doing it. We found out with Ariana that she gives birth to one of these Great One babies. I call them Great One babies, they're not. I forgot what the real name of them are. One of these kin babies. And that is weird that she does that, but it's weird that all of these, a lot of them, in the orphanage, because it's not where they kept women, it's not where they would give birth. So it makes sense. Oh, it's either that or all the kids have become the celestial emissaries. Oh, well, celestial emissary. Where we just see grown people becoming the celestial emissaries. But then again, they might have just grown up. I mean, there's so many unknown things throughout the course of this game. I'm not going to level skill too much if I'm not using a skill weapon right now. I might just upgrade my weapon. And put some gems in them. So might be what's happening up there. I don't know. So much you don't know in this game. In these games. We actually never find a healing church workshop. We only find the workshop. The abandoned workshop, the old workshop. I forgot what it's called. Okay, let's go kill a bloodstarved beast. I might actually just... Boom. Proceed to kill everything. That's running right there. Yeah, okay. I'm not gonna summon. I mean, I could, but what's the big idea? So Blood Slav Beast is kind of cool. For a lot of reasons. Mainly, besides the visual and how good of a boss fight it is. Then also the story behind it, because the reason the back is torn up is because it's so starving for blood. Stop. It's so starving for blood, it ripped its own back up. Trying to get blood out of frustration.
That's pretty metal, dude.
It's dangerous when it poisons. Right there. No, oh, I'm not writing anything to push me. I feel silly, I feel bleeding. Holy shit, okay. Somebody just put up a post on my university Facebook. Whether or not they can borrow Crash Bandicoot. Why would you use a forum with like thousands of people on it used for studies for asking if anybody got a Crash Bandicoot? I mean, it's a fun game, but that is a stupid thing to do. And like, it's fine, you apologize for not being study relevant, but I mean, still not study relevant. I just feel bad about it, like you shouldn't use derogatory terms about it, state. But, I mean, it's not as great, I feel kind of weird about it, because it's not great being retarded. Like, that's the entire point of calling, I mean, I'm fine with people being insulted and, I feel sorry for it. It's a bad word for bad things. Is that the word faggot? Why can I not get the timing on that without fucking everything up? Yeah, I get thrown into that pillar. He gets bit. It's not very... not very good. Oh, bullshit. That's the dangerous one. The one just to stand still and then something to fall. That's the grab.
always kill you unless you have like a million health. Talked about how much of it. I mean, it's not. It's because it's an optional boss. I presume it's why it's so hard. But, I'm gonna pick you up. Okay. Now it gets hard. I was doing so well. One more goes into that. Fucking terrible. I don't know why I do this boss. So, yeah. I don't know. It's a cool boss, but it's kind of boring. It's a female, rips up her own back to get blood, or well, to get the pain, or what she's trying to hit some kind of itch or something. It's a weird boss. It's awesome, though. I think this is a good start. Got a few bosses. We got a bit sassy. Very well, Ned. And I started swearing a lot. Out of pure rage. I'm so high level already. It's really weird. I think I'm not supposed to be this high level. But I'm gonna use all these to get even high level. Don't do this. If you never played the game, don't do this. Always save it for...
Welcome. What is...
That's not enough for two levels.
Very
yeah,
well.
That's exactly why you shouldn't do it. Kind of like the endurance thing.
Farewell,
oh, I think that's good. Well, start off this playthrough. We got a few bosses. I hate myself because I'm playing shitty. And, I'm gonna update this. Well, that's those then. And yeah, my lack of confidence will surely prevail in this playthrough. Actually, the Camellia is the one boss who might be an issue until the Rom. For now. Rom can be a huge bitch. Just trust me on this. Should we buy an item before we move on? Actually, we can quickly look at Gascoigne's armor before we move on. Oh, and we can buy that. And that. Hunter attire worn by Father Gascoigne. Similar to Hunter garb created at the workshop, only these are tainted by a pungent, beastly stench that eats away at Gascoigne. Father is a title used for clerics in a foreign land, and there is no such rank in the Healing Church. The Dingy Scarf is a holy shawl and the symbol of the Healing Church, from which Gascoigne will eventually part ways.
Interesting, because it shows us that Gascoigne is not from from here. He's from somewhere else, and he left the church. Actually, I'm going to buy this set. I like to buy all sets. I normally buy all the armor I can get. He's from somewhere else, and he left the church, likely for his family. Am I out of bullets? Is that what's happening here? Why can't I see my bullets? Why do I only have 6? I actually used all my bullets. Well, that's the rest of my money. I've used a lot of bullets in these fights. Okay. Well, that's it for now, people. I was not supposed to point. Is there a single way to wave? There. See ya. Next time.